out, you know, that put forth their thesis, you know, post-glacial rebound or isotonic adjustment or isostasis, you know, it goes back from 1800s, you know, how this weight is redistributed in the on the planet and how it affects the planet. You know, they've been studying this field for a long time. The thing that they forgot to take in was how it changes the weather patterns, how it changes your tropical areas, how it changes the ocean currents when a mass amount of water is released. You know, their findings were good and solid, but now we're looking at the dynamic firsthand living through it. So you're going from a glacier age to a water age. You know, these are water glaciers. And they're getting stuck in areas because the ocean currents are stalling. So it's just like taking all that weight of those glaciers and sticking it on that area. So you can't look at it as water and land. You take off the water off this earth, it's all land. It's all land. And then when you put this weight over there, and then all of a sudden you take all this new weight and you stick it in that area, it's going to start sinking that ocean floor. New Zealand, you know, those islands are getting the footing chopped out from under them. And they're just going to continue to get major quakes. You've seen Argentina, you know, and Chile, man, those volcanoes are blowing up like crazy, which means there's something more coming that way. And, you know, and I'm just sitting there going, wow. And, I mean, we're seeing livestock dying off like crazy, folks. That ash kills livestock. All those farmers' cattle and sheep or whatever they have, man, they're dying hand over fist. And when you start seeing this go up globally, man, it takes out food crops. You're starting to see these massive thunderstorms. Heck, you're even seeing which causes fires, lots and lots of fires. And that's going to be a big player here, you know. So we got a lot of problems, and we got, you know, electrical problems that are going to cause a lot of fires, and this is just going to increase. You're going to see some pretty interesting dynamics. You know, you're getting static discharge off the rocks. You know, this planet is changing. It's changing fast. You know, it's kind of like that firefighter airplane that went down over there in New Mexico the other day by Roswell, New Mexico. You know, that caught my eye real quick, and I'm going like, oh, wow. You know, and this was a plane that they could fly remote control, you know, is helping with the firefighting stuff. And there was a pilot flying this one, and he ejected out just in time. And then they said that no one could go around the crash site because there was military ordinances on the plane. And I'm thinking, you know, because this plane was mothballed. It was ready to be used for target practice. And that's why they had it remote controlled, you know. And why would it have military ammunition on it if it was there fighting a fire and if it was going to be destroyed? You know, and they cordoned off the area for 80 acres or something like that. And so, you know, something was bizarre about that one. And, you know, but those are the things that make you go, you know, it just didn't add up. So what was going on with that thing? I don't know. You know, it could have got hit with a spacequake, you know, or who knows? You know, but you're going to see more and more military craft go down. You're going to see more airlines go down. You know, I wanted to, matter of fact, I think I called that airplane the TSA Airlines, you know. Isn't that their search thing? What's that called? Is that called TSA? Bob?
No, I think that's something else. It's
you know the pat-down search? What is that called?
Oh, the pat-down, yeah, that's TSA.
Yeah, TSA, yeah. You know, and then when they crash, it's TSA Airlines. See, because apparently this airplane was able to fly on its own if it wanted to. So, you know, okay, aboard TSA Airlines, you know, step on it. Where's the pilot? There is none. You know, oh, and don't go into the walls because there's military ordinances. I just had to bring that one out, man, because, I mean, it was too bizarre. But you're going to see all kinds of changes, folks, big time. You know, if you can, you know, I would suggest you start, you know, having your, you know, ducks in order, because we're going to see changes. Now, if they're going to flip over to the one world banking system this year, which could be, you know, boy, they're just waiting for a natural disaster hit the U.S. to push that one through, because there's no way they're going to be able to pay off all the insurance claims. It's impossible. And since, you know, since they can't work the housing con right now because they just pulled it again, you know, like they did in the 70s with the SNL con. And you know what was interesting? In the 70s, Carter was, oh, he's too much. But, you know, they were having the spacequakes hit then, too. You know, this is a fact that took a long time to happen. You know, this is, you know, our nuclear cowboys, man, is blowing up holes in the ozone and spraying the ice pack with radioactive fallout, you know. It was kind of like the other day, you know, they're chem spraying up, you know. I talked to this guy and I go, oh, yeah, you know, and we're just chit-chatting and stuff. And I go, oh, yeah, so how about that, you know, Freon in that aerosol can? You know, did that help the ozone in it? You know, he goes, what do you mean?
Yeah, he had no clue what you were talking about. Most of these people are just blind to what's going on, Scott. It's crazy. Anyway, Scott, hold that thought. We'll come back in just a moment. We'll take some more calls. Final segment of the Bob Tuscan Show this week. Get on the line if you can, 866-841-1065. All right, folks, final segment of the Bob Tuscan Show. We got Scott from the Believers Underground taking your calls at 866-841-1065. And if you tuned in to the beginning of the second hour of the show when we were talking about this planet marshmallow, a lot of people were skeptical, and I think they have good reason to be skeptical of this, and it seems like there's more to that story. So, Scott, we'll have to look into that a little bit more before we tell the listeners that we should be worried about that. Anyways, there are legitimate concerns to be worried about, and I know you want to talk with Scott, so I'll go right to the phone lines. And we have Chris in Canada online. Chris, how you doing tonight, buddy?
Hey, guys. I love your last caller that mentioned, what was it, pretzels and Coke?
Yeah, he thinks that eating Pringles is going to keep him alive until he's 105.
Yeah, well, I wonder what kind of Coke he's doing.
He's doing Coke mixed with fluoride and aspartame.
Yeah, it's probably the best.
Nothing like it. What's on your mind, Chris?
Well, you guys, actually, I was thinking about chemtrails and all you were talking about, and then and your guest did mention that briefly. I'm a little bit well studied on chemtrails, and I thought this comes into the equation, in my opinion.
Isn't that an oxymoron? A little bit well studied.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, well, that's who I am.
All right. Well, tell us.
I'm a moron.
What are your thoughts?
Well, you know, it's like biofrigins, for example. It never happens with a water vapor barrier. I just did a house today. I just put a vapor barrier on it. So forget the barrier part, but the water vapor. It's color separation only occurs in a crystal index of refraction. Okay? And this is the problem that we're having when we're seeing all this stuff being sprayed above us that people don't believe is being sprayed. They think it's coming from jets, from passenger jets. Prismatic interferences with wavelengths of light only occur with extremely fine solid material. So in other words, what we have here is we have a water vapor that isn't dissipating as it should in the sky above us. So therefore, that would be a chemtrail. And I guess my question would be for your guest is, do you think that might be part of the weather modification?
Yeah.
Or is that just there to poison us?
I've talked about that, Chris, before, and you can type in CNN Shilda Rah, R-A, and it's a radioactive forcing of aerosols project. It's coming out of the ICCP. It costs $5 trillion, and that's just one of their projects, but it's to help fight the feedback effect. The sun hits the glaciers and reflects it back out into space. Well, those glaciers aren't there no more. So it's hitting the ocean floor, and it's or the ocean, and it's absorbing the heat. It's hitting the land masses and absorbing the heat. And it's a domino effect that it just keeps going. But you know what's interesting? You could follow the money. You know, you just follow the money. Back in the 70s, they said, oh, you know, the CO2 stuff is pollution, and they put smog devices on. It had nothing to do with ozone. The ozone was fine. Okay, and then after 86, after Chernobyl blew up and burned four nuclear reactors, 3.5 million pounds of radioactive graphite went globally and went all into the ice, just like all the atomic tests before. But those things burn at 3.5 million degrees hot, man. Those things fry that ozone. And you're just sitting there going, wow. But the next year, 87, they go, we got a hole in the ozone. You know, for the first time in the history of this globe, you got a hole in your ozone. You got a problem. And they go, oh, refrigerant R12 and aerosol sprays. That's what caused it. Okay. Well, you know what they needed? They needed the R12. And they needed all the factories, and they needed all your turn-ins, okay, to start doing their underground facilities. They knew they had a big problem. And all those aerosol factories, this is a global project. I got a 128-page PDF on one of my videos. And if you click the link, there's a 133-page PDF out of the House of Commons showing it that it's up and operational. And it has all the institutions involved in it. I mean, they're all involved in it. it's a global project. You know, this is part of climate security that every country in the world signed into with NATO in 2009.
Yeah, they call it geoengineering. And Chris, does that answer your question?
Yeah, it helps. It definitely helps. I just thought I'd throw that.
Yeah, they're doing it. It's
happening. It's happening in various ways, I guess, and that's just one of some other things I've seen them been doing. They've been doing lately, but it's absolutely, guys. You're doing a great job. I'm glad you guys are talking about this and letting people hear it. So hopefully you're waking up some eyes, and I appreciate what you're doing, guys.
Thank you, and thanks for your call.
Yeah, look up Evergreen Air.
Oh, yeah, we got some good information about that at theintelhub.com. And they also did the budget of the chemtrails, the geoengineering programs, and disclosed that. All sorts of great work. And I met with the EPA officials. We've done a lot on chemtrails. We have to do a full chemtrail show in the future. We've had J. Edward Griffin, Michael Murphy on, a lot of different people. We work with aircraft.org. There's so many different chemtrail websites to deal with. But anyways, thanks again for the call. And I wish we had more time for calls, but we're just about out of time for tonight's show. Scott, any final thoughts?
Well, you know, it's only going to get worse from here, you know, as far as the climate changing. When you got over a foot of water entering into the ocean, you got a problem. And so, you know, take adequate precautions. Panic causes more death than anything. So, you know, having your plan and being prepared and ready is the best, you know, that you can do. And then, you know, move into nicer areas. But every place is going to get hit. So you're by one thing or another. And the food shortages I see coming are going to be, they're going to be big. You know, it's inevitable. You know, and man, I hate giving bunk news, but, you know, the science is, it's there. You know, the Earth's got to fix herself. This incorporated idol that they gave life to back in 1917 with this absolutely corrupt Congress as it gets, you know, giving life to a paper, that's why. What'd you expect? You set up a demagogue, the planet goes to hell. And it did. You know, the third generation of toxic Earth. Drill holes in everywhere, fracked everywhere, sprayed everywhere, changed everything, you know. And I mean, wow. And you got radioactive fallout falling all over people and sterilizing kids and killing fetuses. And I mean, wow, talk about a blood offering to those idols. it just makes you sick to your stomach. But
yeah.
What can you do, man?
It does. Scott, thank you for all that you're doing. Your YouTube channel, The Believers Underground. Scott, thanks, buddy, for coming on.
Love you, man.
Take care.
Talk to you guys later. Bye.
Bye. All right, there he goes, folks. Scott from the Believers Underground wrapping up another week of the Bob Tuscan Show. And I want to thank you all for your emails and comments.